What's going on, motivators? Timothy McCain here. I'm glad you're with me today. I want to share with you about how to conquer dyslexia. I have dyslexia and I struggled with it for as long as I can remember. But there's been some life hacks that I have been doing in my life that has helped me along the way that I wanna share with you. I wanna give you three life hacks that can help you with your dyslexia. First and foremost, as you know, maybe you have dyslexia, you may know someone who have dyslexia. So oftentimes you can read words or numbers flip-flopped, right? And so one thing that I make sure that I do is that before I, and I'm not always good at this, I can tell you, before I post something, I read it three times. So I type it in and I may think that it is perfect. I will wait a few minutes, I'll read it. I'll wait another few minutes, then I'll read it. I'll wait another few minutes, then I'll read it. And then I will post it. And I can't tell you the amount of times that I have wrote something and posted it or sent it and then read it the next day, and it really makes no sense. It's missing keywords, it's missing part of sentences. And what is happening is that I was writing it in my head, I guess, and I just wasn't seeing it, or I thought it, I saw it was there. You know what I mean? And so one thing that I recommend is that you, as you are writing and typing, that you, before you post something, give it a few minutes and give it a couple of repetitions and watch, it'll help you along the way. All right, tip number two. I use an app called Grammarly. When I'm writing papers and when I'm writing emails, I have a MacBook. I'm assuming it works with Windows, but what is great about Grammarly is that while you're writing, it can help catch it for you. So that can help expedite the process. And so Grammarly is to me like a better version of the ABC check that is on Word. You know what I mean? That spell check, that's what I'm saying. It's a greater version of spell check, so it'll check it for you. And so so I love Grammarly, and I highly recommend, there's a free version, there's also a paid version. I'm in college, so really, really, really does help me out a lot there as well. All right, and so my last tip for those who have dyslexia is realize, family, listen, you're not broken. You understand? You are not broken. This is simply something you have to get over. It's not something that's gonna stop you. This is not a wall. There's plenty of people, plenty of celebrities, plenty of celebrities and plenty of people who have dyslexia, who is functional, who is striving, and who is changing this world. And there's no reason why you can't be part of those people. You can't be part of them. So let's make up in our mind that we're not gonna allow dyslexia or this issue in our lives to hinder us, all right? And so these are three tips, and there's so much more. I'm gonna start a whole series on this. I really believe it's gonna help you. But tip number one is before you post it, wait and read it, then post it, right? That repetition of that. Tip number two is that I use a website called Grammarly. Grammarly is, as I'm writing it down, it can help me to see things that I'm missing. Right. But I'm telling you, but the foundation of all of this is tip number three. Realize that you can do it. There's a strength within you greater than what you realize. And maybe you feel like that you can't because you have been so many fingers pointing at you saying that you have this. So you just cope with it. Don't cope, conquer. Get rid of excuses. I've been saying this since in this YouTube channel for a while. There's a difference between impossibilities and difficulties. And maybe you have deemed dyslexia as something that has been impossible for you to conquer. So you have made up in your mind not to try at all. But listen, it's not impossible. It's just difficult. All right. And so there's some things you have to strive through, things you have to conquer. And I believe you can do it. So motivators, do me a favor. I need you to share this video because there's many people walking with dyslexia, struggling with dyslexia, and has coped in the saying, well, I just can't be this. I can't do that. I can't be a public speaker because I can't do this, can't do that. Listen, that's a lie. That is a lie. That is an excuse. You may thought it was a reason. That's an excuse. And I feel like, man, I'm living my best life with dyslexia, but not coping with it conquering, be able to travel around the world sharing and speaking, and you know what, and maybe I have some hiccups along the way. Maybe I still stutter and I still slur, because I do. But you know what, I refuse to fail than fear, and I refuse to allow that to be the anchor that sits me in the ocean of my dreams, looking at my promises from afar, because I made up in my mind to cope. But listen, you are more than a conqueror. So my people, my motivators, let me tell you, maybe you have dyslexia. Let's start this conversation. What are some tips that you do that helps you in your journey? I want to hear your ideas in the comment section below. All right, now family, know what you got to do. You got to like, comment, and subscribe, and let's share this good news, this news all around the world. All right, be blessed.